So Newton's law of pulling. Newton's law of pulling says that if you have one object and that object is having certain temperature which is higher than the temperature of the surrounding in which it is kept, then gradually it will lose heat to the surrounding and cools down. Now, how fast the object will cool, how fast the object will radiate heat to the surrounding, what is the rate of interactions with the surrounding, that is explained with Newton's law of pulling. The rate of pulling is explained here. It says that if theta is the temperature of the object and theta naught is the temperature of the surrounding, then the rate of loss of heat, that is dQ by dT, is directly proportional to the excess of temperature of the body over the surrounding. That is the difference of the temperature between the object and surrounding. So this is what is known as Newton's law of pulling. And in Newton's law of pulling, or this law is applicable when the difference in temperature is small. Okay. So let us first see the write down the law and we will explain that. If theta is the temperature of the body and theta naught is the temperature of the surrounding, so they are in degree centigrade, then the heat that it emits per second, that is this is the law, the excess of temperature, the difference of the temperature of the body over the surrounding. Okay, if the temperature is same, then there will be excess of heat, but then whatever heat that it will emit per second, the same amount of heat it will absorb per second. So there is no net change in the temperature of the body. That is the first theory of heat exchange. But here, there is a difference in temperature, and we say that this theta is greater than theta naught. So the body is supposed to cool and the environment is supposed to get heated. So if I remove the proportionality, I get a constant, that is proportionality constant I have to introduce. Let us see what equation we are getting. This is Q is for heat and T was the time of the time that you allow the heat to flow. Now TQ, some constant, say C, theta minus theta naught, and I can put minus here also because there is a loss, so I can put minus here. In some books it is there,
some books they don't write minus, but we can write minus because it is a loss. What is cooling? Now, if we want to write the in terms of the temperature or of loss of temperature, that is in terms of cooling, we know that Q is ms theta. If a body has temperature theta, and to get that temperature, the amount of heat that I have supplied is Q. If I supply dQ, amount of heat, then temperature rise by d theta. So if I divide dT here, both sides, I have this expression as the rate of flow of heat. Here is the rate of cooling if the temperature is if the body is losing temperature. In fact, here it is a case of cooling. So in place of dq by dt, I can substitute this value over there. So what I will have here, I can write d theta upon dt as theta naught. This again is a constant. This S stands for specific heat, M is the mass of the object, that was kept in the surrounding medium, C is a constant that was introduced earlier, so whole thing is a constant. So again, this is a constant, so I will say minus K. So where the, this whole is replaced by this K. Now, if I look at this equation, this basically stands for rate of cooling. This is rate of loss of heat.